In this video, I'm reviewing another LEGO Legends of Chima speedo set. This is set number 70101. This is the target practice. And the set is one minifigure. It came out in 2013 with 1 and 1 pieces. And yeah, the Chima line hasn't been too popular among LEGO fans. But for the small minority, I think it may be interesting. And the speedo has those propellers here, and we get the ripcord here, and you can put that through the speedo, and you get this torpedo launcher here to knock out the Raven target there, which I think is a very cool feature. And I think that's what makes some of these Chima sets interesting, some of the play features, pieces, and the minifigures. Not the story. The story was very, very weak. And as I'm trying to hit the last target, I would like to know which is your favorite and least favorite Legends of Chima set and speedo, and what your favorite and least favorite part of the set is. And if you had the budget to buy this one, would you pick this one up? So it's a very quick and easy build, and boom, there's the target. the games are not that fun, but I think the play features are interesting. As I mentioned before, here's the torpedo launcher, and there are no stickers, everything is printed on, so that's good. And here's the back of the launcher with the targets there, which is the modified tile there. And there we get the three targets, one with the red dish there, the other one has the yellow, and the other one the green trash can lid. And I think these are very quick and easy builds, and they look fancy and effective, and they do their job. And now let's check out the speedo, which has some very nice prints. And as I mentioned before, we get these propellers there for the power up, which I think is very interesting as well. And there we have the minifigure inside the speedo. We get the ripcord there, and we get the 6 G crystals. And now let's check out the minifigure. And this is Ikila, and he has the battle axe and the spear. And there he is from the back, and now without the accessories from the back, which are going to be covered up there, which is unfortunate. And what's also interesting is that the minifigure doesn't have a special molded head mold. So that would have been very, very interesting and collectible if you ask me, but oh well, it is how it is. And here's the set again, and here's instructions. There are no mistakes, no missing pieces. It's definitely a very, very fun and quick build if you are into the build, not the storyline, of course. Here's the battle cards. You get 5 of them with the set, and they have some very interesting artworks there. And that's about it for the cards. And here we have the packaging. And here's the back of the box, or the blister, I should say. And you get the other sets here, and the play features. And I think it's a very interesting set. And yes, I got minor clearance. And yeah, very decent build. And here's the front of the box. I think for $8 it was a no-brainer here. Speedo, what can I say, other than the theme flopped? Well, the minifigures are interesting and collectible. You get some interesting pieces for custom stuff, maybe some interesting play features and building tactics, but other than that, not really. So this is set number 70101. This is the target practice.